Recently, in an eye-opening interview with Democracy Now!, Hugh Kaufman, a senior policy analyst at the EPA's Office of Solid Waste and Emergency Response, made this shocking admission. And I quote, "I think the media now has to follow the money, just as they did in Watergate, and tell the American people who's getting money for poisoning the millions of people in the Gulf," end quote. Now, this came from the EPA's Office of Solid Waste and Emergency Response. And continuing on, as Alexander Higgins in Democracy Now! Points out, Hugh Kaufman has been at the EPA since the agency was created in the early 1970s. As an engineer, investigator, and policy analyst, prior to joining the EPA in the beginning of 1971, he was a captain in the U.S. Air Force. He helped write all the federal laws regulating the treatment, storage, disposal, and remediation of solid and hazardous waste. He's been the chief investigator on numerous contamination cases, including Love Canal and Times Beach. Now, let me go back to the quote of the man we just described. Quote, "And I think the media now has to follow the money, just as they did in Watergate, and tell the American people who's getting money for poisoning the millions of people in the Gulf." Like I said, that is something I wish I had written, but it was just, I had to read it. It's my words as well. I am very glad I was able to be sent that link. And now I would like to try to wrap up what I was trying to wrap up about the symptoms yesterday on our premiere show. That was August 21st, if you want to go to the archives. And by the way, we have the archives not only on Blog Talk Radio under WVP Radio, but we also have it on our World Vision Portal .org site, and just pop around and look for WVP Radio, and you'll see our archives there as well. Now, yesterday I was talking about symptoms. I quickly went over them. I've posted on our site in support of the broadcast yesterday and today. I posted actual symptoms that were reported and are verified. You have the sources. You have links, as well as some other information about certain viruses or plagues that, oddly enough, the Gulf flu, as they're calling it, of which my word is the blue flu, that those symptoms that are being reported firsthand, they appear to mimic certain viruses or plagues, which kind of astounded me. I've been thinking, like everybody else, that this is flu-like symptoms only. And it ends up that it's more than the flu, especially when you look at the symptoms, you read the symptoms, and then you compare them to viruses and things like this, which are deadly diseases, some of these viruses. And that's the scary part. Now, I'm not saying that the symptoms are a virus. I'm not coming out to say that at all. I'm saying they mimic the same symptoms, and I'm going to leave it up to everybody who goes to the World Vision Portal and looks this up for themselves. I'll tell you where to find it right now. If you go to the World Vision Portal, it's under the category called the Earth. And then you need to click Gulf of Mexico, and under that, it shows blue plague symptoms. Go to worldvisionportal.org. You can read this for yourself. I'm not going to repeat everything that's on there. I'm going to repeat some highlights and let you make your own decision of why these symptoms of viruses, which are actually plagues, seem to match the symptoms that these people working in the Gulf and those living on the Gulf, not just the workers, these symptoms match, and it's scary. Now, I'm not saying it's these particular kind of viruses or plagues, but I will say it's too close for comfort. I don't like reading it. I live on the Gulf. I don't want to know about this. Well, let me get to the full list, which is in that that link on our site, the full list of the reported golf of which I call blue flu symptoms. That's my name for it. It's the blue flu. There are 25 of them that I put together out of different articles, which you'll see that are all sourced in there. So nobody can say that this is a conspiracy deal going on, that I'm making anything up. Yesterday's program were quotes of actual victims with their own words about their symptoms. So let's just go down the list. For those of you that don't have access to the internet, you're on your iPod or your iPhone or whatever, let me just run it by you. We have a total of 25 that I've put together so far of what articles that I have found and testimonies from people. Eyes burning and watering, severe headaches, nausea, upset stomach, shortness of breath, difficulty breathing, respiratory problems, sore, swollen, or burning throats, nosebleeds, chronic fatigue, severe nasal irritation, achiness, a wet hacking cough, a burning mouth, brown-colored vomit and urine, profuse sweating, chest congestion, and coughing, lethargy, weakness, chronic fatigue, impaired memory. And I spoke about that one last night with a man who gave his testimony at Publix. He almost didn't know where he was. Moving on, number 17 is elevated blood pressure, loss of consciousness, chemically induced pneumonia, gagging, diarrhea, vomiting, bleeding from the rectum, heart palpitations, and muscle spasms. Now, those are the 25 categories of symptoms of people who have reported those symptoms who live on the Gulf or have worked for BP's Vessels of Opportunity program, or from those who have been interviewed by others, of which all of this is linked. The sources are all there if you go to the link on worldvisionportal.org. Now, something that was brought up to my attention about a week ago, which I thought was pretty interesting, dengue fever in Key West, Florida. I don't know if this is connected or not, but when you listen to the symptoms, it just might possibly be connected. Now, this was from August 3rd, and it was on CNN. It said, the Florida Department of Health confirmed an increase in the number of cases of dengue fever acquired in the Key West area. And I want to tell you, I am very familiar with dengue fever. I spent a lot of time in West Africa. I know the symptoms of dengue fever. I know how it can be fatal. I know how it works. I know how it can take an entire village in Nigeria and just wipe them out. Continuing with the article, new statistics from the department, and we're talking about Florida Department of Health, said 24 cases of dengue fever have been reported in Key West through mid-July. Now, there's been no report since then. Nobody's reported on it. I find it a little odd if they say it all disappeared, but maybe it did. Continuing on, of those, 18 involve Key West residents. 5 are residents of other Florida counties, and 1 case involves a resident of another state. Now, this is the official Florida Department of Health report. Symptoms appear 3 to 14 days after the bite of an infected mosquito, according to the Florida Department of Health. Now, these symptoms include sudden onset of fever, severe headache, severe pain behind the eyes, muscle, joint, and bone pain, which, by the way, gave the disease the nickname breakbone fever, and bleeding. Gastrointestinal symptoms such as vomiting and diarrhea may also be present in some cases. Dengue fever symptoms usually last 4 to 7 days. It's often diagnosed incorrectly because the symptoms are similar to influenza and other viruses. Dengue hemorrhagic fever is a rare but more severe form of dengue infection that can be fatal if not recognized and treated. Now, let me just go through that there are basically, we just got to dengue hemorrhagic fever. I'm not saying the blue flu, what I'm calling the blue flu, the Gulf flu, I'm not saying it's dengue hemorrhagic fever. However, it's kind of odd to me the report with many of the symptoms all of a sudden says we have this in Key West. Now, hemorrhagic fevers, they're viruses. They're viral, and they're infectious. They can be by mosquitoes, be from a mosquito bite as dengue fever is. Yellow fever is the same way. I saw a lot of that when I was spending time in Africa. Those things are familiar to me, but I'm just going to tell you very quickly, hemorrhagic fevers, the most common are dengue, which we just spoke about, Ebola, Lassa, Marburg, which is actually a type of Ebola, and yellow fever, which, again, is mosquitoes. No current treatment can cure any of those hemorrhagic fevers. There is no cure. And immunizations exist for only a few types. Now, I've had yellow fever shots, never got yellow fever. But then again, I never had any kind of anything to prevent malaria. And after 9 years in and out of West Africa, I never got malaria. I must be lucky. Well, until additional vaccines are developed, the only way is prevention. So if you go to Africa, you're from U.S. or even Europe, there's no guarantee you're not going to get it. But let's go into dengue fever symptoms. It's a disease ranging from mild and severe, caused by four related viruses spread by a particular species of mosquito. Okay, again, there might not be any tie with this other than certain symptoms that are in common between this and the Gulf flu or the blue flu, as I call it. Mild dengue fever causes a high fever, rash, which is one of the symptoms of blue flu, and muscle and joint pain, another symptom, along with the fever. So there's the three most common dengue fever symptoms are being the same symptoms that are with the people who have been working around the Gulf and who live on the Gulf Coast. More severe symptoms of the disease, dengue hemorrhagic fever and dengue shock syndrome, which is when it really gets serious, can additionally cause severe bleeding, which if you remember the symptoms I read about the Gulf flu was part of it, maybe not severe, but bleeding nonetheless, sudden drop in blood pressure, which was one of the Gulf flu symptoms, and death. Now, I reported on yesterday's program on August 21st about the one worker who had basically whatever it was or pouring into the Gulf, and they were on one of the spray boats where he had it spilled directly on his arms and a little bit in his face. And according to the Vietnamese refugee captain of that boat, that undocumented worker died within a couple hours right after they got him back to the dock. All I can say is that was sent to me. I know the man only through somebody that I know very well. I trust what he says. I can't vouch for him. I only know him in relation to a very trusted person. So take that for what it's worth.